Now.
Local, live, late breaking. This is West 2 News First at 4.
Breaking news out of Volusia County. Port Orange police find human remains in the backyard of an accused rapist. After 2 days of digging, investigators removed the remains just a few hours ago. Good afternoon. I'm Martha Sagowski.
And I'm Stuart Moore. Jim is off. 43-year-old James Maxwell was arrested in December after he allegedly snuck into his neighbor's home and kidnapped the child. He's been held without bond since then. Police say this new crime is far older and Maxwell is the suspect. West 2 broke the story of the dig yesterday, and Claire Metz is live on the scene right now with more information. And Claire, what's the latest with this case?
Well, Stuart, I'll tell you what. When James Maxwell was arrested for kidnapping and raping a neighbor child here in December, residents here, the neighbors, were just shocked and appalled to find out he had a previous criminal history. He served about a year and a half of a 9-year sentence for attempted murder. He had burglary convictions following that. Well, now he is a murder suspect.
We are treating this as a homicide. We are going to be doing an autopsy on the human remains tomorrow.
After several days of digging, police make a grim discovery. The badly decomposed body of an adult buried in this yard here at least a year, probably longer. An adult, but that's all police are saying, except for one very important detail.
I'm not going to beat around the bush here. James Maxwell is a suspect in this case.
James Maxwell, pictured here in December being arrested during a takedown after the Port Orange man allegedly kidnapped his 9-year-old neighbor from her bed following a holiday party, then held her for hours raping her. Now, he's a suspect in another heinous crime. Neighbors are just stunned.
I hope they don't find anything, but if they do, I know it's going to be closure for someone who lost a loved one.
Police say Maxwell's girlfriend, who lives here and with whom he has a child, was going to have plumbing work done at the house. He became very upset about any yard construction. And two different people, our sources say the girlfriend, one of them, called police.
We're not going to identify who it is, although let me say this to you, that we have a good idea who the individual is.
Police also have a good idea of how the victim was murdered, but again, those details are not being released. Police got a partial hit from cadaver dogs yesterday. Ground radar detection led them to the remains. The digging continues just in case, but
we do not believe there are any other bodies in the yard.
We're back live now. Chopper 2 showing you live pictures of James Maxwell's yard. Chopper 2 was first on the scene last night as well when we learned all of this was unfolding. Now, again, they don't believe anyone else is buried in the yard, but they want to be absolutely certain. So the digging will continue today and possibly into tomorrow. Police also are getting a search warrant so they can go into James Maxwell's home and look for other evidence there. Now, of course, a question in all of our minds: who is this victim? As you heard, police believe they know who that person is, but are not releasing that information. We have several missing people in the Volusia County area. We've done stories on some of them, and I'm sure their families are wondering the same thing right now. But police say it will take probably a month before they positively identify the remains through DNA. So it could be a while. They want it to happen as quickly as possible to give some closure to the families. Reporting live in Port Orange, Volusia County, Claire Metz, West 2 News.
Happening right now, Marion County.